to understand the hold heroin has on our community, we're following the lives of five young people. They've all overdosed or been arrested, and two died in the past 3 months.
I could never actually figure out a way to just feel better. You know, even using heroin wasn't working. And it was scary.
I remember pouring a little bit out on my center console, and that's the last thing I remember. My boyfriend said he was slapping me, pinching me, like anything to wake me up, nothing.
If I could just get clean, I could beat it, but being sick, I can't get past the sick. And she was clean, and she comes out, and she makes it about 2 weeks, and she's right back at it.
I mean, you meet people, and you'll run with them for a few months, and next thing you know, you get a phone call, and they're dead.
That you're not gonna use.
Need a video of this.
No, but you just tell me. You promised me right there on video.
I promise you. I'll call you every day.
From where? No.
Stop.
No.
I finally broke down, and it was God's strength within me to stand up and just say I need help. I had my appendix removed and then got prescribed oxycodone, and then from then on, I didn't have standards for myself. I didn't care. I said, just give me whatever's in front of my face and I'll just take it, just to escape from reality and run from what life's become.
This is God. I don't know where to start. I don't know how to fix myself, but you say there is hope. I don't even know what to fix. His bedroom door was locked, and I'm like, Robbie, and he didn't answer. And I thought, if I could just save the world, then maybe I'll get to keep my son.